Hello, Sophie here. So there is a new grease pencil feature as of Blender 3.4 that has changed my workflow. I have been using it nonstop for a few weeks now. I made a video about that new feature. If you'd like to learn more about it, you can here. But in this video, I want to talk about the new brushes that I made for this feature. This is a collection of textured grease pencil brushes created from real ink and watercolor textures that I made myself, scanned and digitized. Plus some digital patterns thrown in there as well. These brushes are available through my Gumroad that will be linked below if you would like to download them as well. So I made 5 different types of brushes in all, and each type is included in its own blend file. So this is just the texture file now. Each brush has a radius that is affected by pen pressure, so that these strokes get thicker the harder I press with my stylus. They have a flat caps type because this helps me to save on geometry. And I also quite like the look of the rectangular strokes that I'm able to get. In the post-processing for these brushes, I've also given them a simplify value of 0.05. Again, saving on geometry is pretty important for me when I make art with thousands of strokes. But these are all settings that can be modified based on your own preferences. And of course, we also have the outline active in the post-processing. And so each brush has a different material selected for this stroke outline. And this is what gives us these different brushes. The last important setting to note is that in the brush settings, each brush has a solid stroke material pinned to it. So this is the material that allows us to make stroke shapes. And by pinning it, this means that I can go and select other materials in my materials properties tab so that I can modify them. And when I go back to draw, I will still be using this solid stroke material. So I will talk more about modifying materials later on in this video, but this setting is a big time saver for me. So now let's talk about adding brushes to your projects. Each brush pack actually has 2 blend files. The main one is the one that I was just drawing in. I use this file to test out the brushes within the file itself. I can just open the file and start drawing and see how I like using these brushes. But the second blend file with append in the title is the one that I recommend using to import these brushes into your own different files from. So the difference here with this file is that rather than having a solid stroke material pinned to each brush, the pinned material is actually the same as the outline material. And this is because when I go to append these brushes into a new file, I do this by going into File, Append. I click on the append version of the blend file. I go into the brushes folder. And then all my brushes start with SJ, so I can click, hold shift click to append a bunch of them all at once. And here they are. So appending in this way also includes whatever materials are associated with the brush. So both the pinned active material and the outline material as well. But we also need to add these materials to our current stroke grease pencil object. So what happens when I select one of these brushes and I draw with it is that instantly the pinned active material gets added to our materials list and included within this stroke object. So what I do is I go through each brush, I draw a stroke with it, any shape at all, just to have the materials all be included in my stroke object. And then I select the solid stroke material. So this comes included in a Blender 2D animation starter file. It's really just a stroke with a line type and a solid style. So I select that and then I can go to each brush and change the pinned material by just double clicking on this pin. It will be instantly changed to the solid stroke. And just like that, in under a minute, I have set up all of these new brushes in my blend file. If I were to append brushes from the other blend file, the first one, which has the stroke pinned, the solid stroke material pinned as the active material, and I tried to draw with it, the outline material would not be immediately added to my file, and we would get this. The solid stroke material does get added, which I don't need because I already have one in this file, and I actually would need to manually add from this dropdown the different materials so that then I can use these brushes with those materials. And so it's a bit of a trade-off one way or the other, but the first method that I've described is the one that I personally find easier and quicker. And also, when it comes to my personal favorite brushes, the ones I use across many artworks, I can set it up so that they're already there each time I open up a new 2D animation workspace by going through the process of appending them, and then I can go into File, Defaults, Save Startup File so that they will always open up with every new blend file that I open. So the textures of this brush pack are all black and white repeating texture images. You can check out this video I made about how I created them and set them up using Krita. But so these are textures that tile infinitely within Blender. Sometimes, especially for big swatches, the tiling pattern can be pretty obvious. But in general, within a single stroke I make, how I usually use strokes, how I usually draw with Blender, I really don't notice it that much. So the way the textures show up within strokes has to do with how the stroke is drawn, specifically the start of the stroke. The way the texture shows up will change if I draw the stroke upwards, from left to right, or diagonally. And sometimes it is a bit finicky and the results can be unexpected. And so if I do have a specific look that I want to get for a stroke, then I may undo and redo a few times to get that specific look. But usually I just make strokes freely and get the overall look of the texture. And the cover images of all of these brushes all show how the texture looks when it's drawn going upward. So these textures are inserted into grease pencil as fill materials with a style of texture, and then I insert the image into here. The base colors are all black, but I don't use the base colors at all because the blend value is raised to 1, meaning that these are all fully affected by the vertex color palette. Note that at the time of filming this, this feature only works with vertex colors in the 3.5 version of Blender. And so that is the one that I have been using it ever since I could use it, because this is amazing. So each material contains only a fill, no stroke at all. The stroke portion of the material is unchecked, and every fill texture also has settings. So I personally modified these based on my own preferences, my own tests, but these can all be modified. If I'm gonna modify any of these settings, it's usually the scale. I'll bring a texture into a piece that I'm working on, and I may realize that the scale of the texture doesn't really match with the piece that I'm making, with how big I want the scale to be to go along with the rest of this piece. And so I may scale it up or down, and I will also change the X and Y locations as necessary, because I want to make sure that at the start of strokes, the texture shows up how I want it to. Since small strokes like this are the ones that I make most often when I work, this is prime texture real estate, and so I'm very intentional about the X and Y locations. And note that I am making all of these changes to the texture in the Materials Properties tab, but I'm still able to go and draw with this brush normally, even with this material selected. Thank you, active solid stroke material. So far in this video, I've been using the texture pack to illustrate everything, but there are 4 other packs included as well. The watercolor brushes are a personal favorite of mine. We have some very transparent brushes, great for layering on top of one another. There are some brushes with a lot of texture and blotches, and there are some opaque brushes, great for outlining. The speckle brushes add speckles, spots, and blobs and bubbles of varying sizes, varying opacities, varying textures. I have a big collection of fur brushes next because I am an animal artist after all. So these ones I'll use very intentionally. I'll make a stroke, and by being mindful of the direction of my stroke and by keeping my stroke quite short, I'm able to get strands of fur texture. This is a case where I tend to undo and redo quite a bit to get the look how I want it. So some brushes I love using for the edge of an animal's fur. Others are great for using in the middle of an animal's coat. Some of these are more naturalistic and very textured, and other ones are very abstract. Speaking of abstract, that brings us perfectly to my final pack, my pattern brushes. Because is there even a point to making art if you can't very easily add a star pattern to everything? I really love combining graphic designs like this with my more naturalistic style. I think it can make for a really interesting, really fun combination. And that is a summary of my brushes. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, definitely let me know, and I hope that you enjoy using these brushes as much as I do. If you'd like a more in-depth look at my workflow, my process using grease pencil, you can check out my Patreon, where you'll be able to access my blend files and see videos of my process in real time, see me talk through my process in real time, and you can find me all over the internet at Sophie Jantak. I hope you're doing well. I will see you very soon. Take care. Bye.